Hello, this is Bern, and if you're somewhat confused as to why some guys promise things that they don't deliver or seem to really want to commit but can't commit or don't commit, on today's episode, I'll be sharing with you some key mindset distinctions that will enable you to look at men differently and stop wasting time on guys who can't do this. Stick with me. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your greatlifetobe.com. Today's another edition of Get the Love You Crave. Every week I get contacted by a woman who is sharing with me how the guy seemed to be close to the finish line and in the end he just didn't do it, or he disappeared, or he ghosted her despite promises, despite really good intentions, despite saying, here's what I want to do. They just weren't able to pull it through. And I'd love to share with you a distinction that will help you avoid wasting your precious time with men who seem overexcited but don't necessarily have the ability to give you what you're looking for. The distinction is there are two quintessential, take your notepad please, quintessential forces present in a man that will enable him to take you to the finish line. Finish line being lifelong commitment or marriage and children or something deep and profound. First one is his intentions, right? Because here's the thing, if a guy doesn't even have the intention to go to a certain place, then it's lost before it's even started. But if a guy has intentions, that's one of the forces. And by the way, let me just define intentions quickly here. Definition of intentions by the dictionary is the determination to act a certain way. Now, I'm not going to use that definition. I'm going to lower the notch a little bit and say not the determination, but the desire to act a certain way. That's the definition that I have for intentions right now. A guy wants something, right? Second force that's present and important is his capacity. And capacity means the ability to deliver on said intentions. Here is the thing. Not just men, human beings by nature will have lots of intentions without the capacity sometimes, or the hunger, or the commitment to follow through on those intentions. And let me give you some examples, okay? Imagine that you say, well, I want to be an Olympian. I'm watching the Olympics. I'm a five-year-old kid, and I would love to be there one day. That's the intention. I'd love to be an Olympian. Now, what's required to be an Olympian is wake up at 5 in the morning for the next 10 years of your life, go to the swimming pool and take 3 hours. I mean, like when your friends are playing, you're practicing swimming. And when your friends are on vacation, you're swimming camp. That's what's required to be an Olympian. It's a lot of work, a lot of sacrifice, right? So although human beings by nature want certain things, they don't necessarily have the hunger to pursue it. And sometimes they have the hunger and they just don't have the chops. I mean, I would love to be a basketball player, but 5'4", it's not going to happen, right? So here's the thing. If you find yourself in a situation where you haven't been able to gauge whether, I mean, or you've been with men and you believe what they're saying, but you haven't been able to land that yet, and almost like it's caught you by surprise, where it's like, oh my God, he was saying the right things, but he just didn't follow through. Here's a few things, in addition to understanding the concept, the difference between capacity and intentions, that will help you. Here's some ways that you can start evaluating the capacity to deliver on intentions. The first one is his ability to produce results in life. So take his life into context and say, how frequently does this man produce results? Can he produce results in life? Can he produce income? Can he produce his dreams, the things that he wants? Is he going towards them? Is he meeting them? Does he have that capacity? Because that's going to, I mean, the capacity to do certain things sometimes has the foundation to do other things. Why? Because it's discipline. It's doing things sometimes when you don't want to. It's having courage. It's having vulnerability. So that's part of what you want to evaluate. Something else you want to evaluate is his capacity to overcome obstacles. Why? Because you will have to overcome significant obstacles to be in a lifelong relationship with someone, probably more than in any other thing. Why? Because it requires everything, everything of you and everything of the other person. It's a strong commitment. So also, I think you can start measuring is not just his capacity to produce results, but his capacity to overcome obstacles. When shit hits the fan, how does he deal with it? How does he transcend the pain? Is he a guy who talks about solutions or mainly talks about problems? Is he a visionary or is he a Debbie Downer / Eeyore that's talking about the pain in life and how messed up he is? Does he have a victor or a victim mentality? That gives you a little bit of context regarding capacity, right? Desire, I'll give you another one. Desire for depth versus desire for excitement. Now, here's the truth. I am a man, so I want both. I want depth and excitement. But here's the situation. Sometimes depth, if depth is what you're going for, sometimes you'll have to sacrifice some excitement in the way of getting that depth. That means that if you, for example, want a long-term relationship and there's flashy objects, meaning thousands of beautiful women around you, if your commitment is to excitement, you're going to say, well, fuck the depth. I'm just going to go and connect with all these women, right? But if your commitment is to depth, doesn't mean that you don't want to do it. It just means that you'll say, it's the depth I'm looking for is worth the sacrifice of not connecting with other women. Same thing you'll do in connection with him, right? So that's another thing to gauge. His desire for depth at his stage in life versus his desire for flashy objects, fun, meaningless or not as meaningful connections. Another thing that will allow you to gauge his capacity for future commitments, integrity. And integrity in this specific form, words versus actions, meaning does he honor his word? When he says something, does he follow through? When he promises something, small things, is he following through? Is he lying about little things? If he's lying about little things, lying about bigger things is easier, right? So where is he center of integrity? Where is the center of integrity in terms in relationship to you, in relationship to his family, in relationship to his work, in relationship to his ethic around people around him? That's something else that you need to measure. Next thing you can measure is compatibility, because you can have a guy who can produce results, who can overcome obstacles, who has a desire for depth versus excitement, and who has integrity, but there's something missing. There's the chemistry sometimes missing, or sometimes it's the compatibility because his vision for life is different than yours. So you can have all those things, but if the compatibility in heart and excitement and also vision are not shared, then it's absolutely worthless to you that that guy has all those things, because you're not going anywhere. You're not going on the same road. You're not going to the same destination. One last thing that is the mother or father of all those things, and that's time. You need to be able to gauge these things across time. So when somebody says, well, I mean, I connect with this guy and just like out of the blue, he just ghosted me. And I said, well, how long did you know him for? Well, a month and a half. Well, okay, a month and a half. You have no idea who he is. Sorry to say this, as much heart and vulnerability as you're putting into this, month and a half, you still have no freaking idea of who the man is. So time is an important factor as well. Okay, so to recap, my dear, if you want to find out why some guys can't deliver, it's because they have high intentions, low capacity to deliver those intentions. And what I gave you right now is a framework of a few qualities that you can start gauging more proactively to know if the guy is promising bullshit he can't deliver, or if he's promising things that he has the full capacity and coglioni/cojones/balls to make happen. Okay? Hope this is helpful, useful, and exciting to you in some way. If it is, I'm going to ask you to do three things. First thing is click like on this video or thumbs up. You can even click on the little bell if you don't want to miss out my future videos. Number two is subscribe to my channel. And number three, if you want to learn how to create the relationship that you want with less pain and with less frustration than you have in the past, then on the first line of the description of this video, I have a link that will take you to a website that will share with you a masterclass I created just for you. It's absolutely free. Now, if you're learning all this stuff and you say, Bern, I love the videos and I love the masterclass and this is really cool, but I've done this on my own and I've attempted all these things for me and I want some hand-holding through the process. I don't want to waste via trial and error the next 5 years of life trying to figure this shit out. Can you help me? The answer is potentially yes. There's also a link on the description of this video if you want to find out if we're fit to work together, where we can connect, and if we are, then we can work together so you don't have to attempt to do this alone. Thank you so much for connecting with me. As always, I challenge you, live a full and a conscious life. Mwah.